LeBron James and Kawhi Leonard need to team up to defeat the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Kawhi Leonard's going to have to play in that scenario, so let's not forget that aspect of it as well. But I do think we're at the point now where something monumental is going to happen this offseason, just as it kind of has in recent years, you know, with KD going to the Warriors and such. It just feels like something big is going to happen, and this postseason has kind of reinforced you're not going to beat the Warriors, and the Celtics, God, what are they going to be when Hayward and Kyrie comes back? We need to do something drastic to compete. And whether it is going to Philly or Houston or something, I think someone's going to have to really make a big move to make a splash.
This is why Kawhi is so intriguing to me in this scenario, because every time one of these teams is playing the Warriors, you say, what do they do with Kevin Durant? Because
right.
he's roasting everybody in one-on-one coverage, and most teams don't have someone that can stay with him the whole game. And
right.
let's say it was the Cavs against the Warriors. LeBron can't do what he does on offense and cover Kevin Durant. That's ridiculous.
He'd be dead by halftime.
On a team with Kawhi Leonard, you right. do have somebody that you can say, all right, go get that guy.
And look at the Rockets. They have guys who should, you know, in theory, really, you know, go well against Kevin Durant. They have Trevor Ariza, Luke Mbah-Amute, P.J. Tucker. These aren't bad options to throw at Kevin Durant. He's just that good. Kawhi Leonard might be, well, maybe the only guy that really matches up well and you can leave him on an island.